Hello friends, welcome back to a new video. Now today I have to out myself as an absolute fanboy. And that is especially because over the last year I found myself looking at different creators, looking at their travel videos, all that cinematic kind of stuff, cool transitions and so on. And one person that still stands out to me and also to you, that's why you've been suggesting to watch this video over and over again, is Mr. Benn TK. And today we're gonna look at his video from the Philippines, and that one was absolutely crazy, especially that intro. So today let's look at Benn TK's video, Philippines, Land of Enchanted Islands. It's gonna be crazy. As always, if you haven't watched the video before, go click the link in the description, watch the video on his channel first. Now let's jump over and analyze his video.
We often choose places in this world to visit for different reasons, whether it be to feel the warmer weather on tropical islands or to experience the diverse cultures and landscapes that differ from home. But sometimes those places, they can choose us too.
Important with any video, what I see so often in beginner videos is they don't give an introduction, they don't give a story, they don't have a voiceover. And here he's setting the story right away. And it's getting crazy. That is so cool. The level of detail that he put into this intro is so crazy. And it all looks so real. Oh, nah.
Ben?
That intro was so good. And did you even know that he had a behind the scenes video on his channel where he also showed how they recorded that? Here with the green screen.
That way.
Perfect.
It looks so ridiculous when you see the behind the scenes, and then how the actual video looked like was so good. And for the wind, they use a f***ing leaf blower. And you didn't see any of that in the final video. The chair wasn't there. And how he actually put all of that in, and then in that moment it's going so fast. The movement of all the pieces is so rapid and so blurry that you cannot see anything. Level of genius that it takes to be able to do all that. I don't know how many hours of editing it just took to make that intro. That alone was so crazy. But now let's get into the rest of the video.
Ben?
Dropping the thing. And he comes shooting there. Even hear these flicker effects? They're crazy.
Am I in the Philippines?
Am I in the Philippines?
Oh man.
Super nice. Even the special extra detail with putting in that butterfly there. Wow, that is so nice. And here with that shot, like, looks like it's shot on a gimbal, and then here fast forwarded, and then you see motion, a lot of motion blur, and super smooth transition how the handlebar comes here. That is one thing that he's so insanely good about, making the transition so smooth and seamless. Here. Like, you don't even see the cuts anywhere. Here, where's the cut? It gets blurry. Here, you see it gets all. Now the music's building up, and then also here all the sound effects. I've seen a couple of pictures on his Instagram whenever he's showing all the layers that he has on his videos, and it's like blows my mind when there's like 10, 15 audio layers. I already get crazy when I have 4 or 5 audio layers. Transitions are so smooth, you barely see where the cut is. Here, through the grass, cuts through the grass, and that's why those shots match so well together. Here, for example, from this shot to the next one, pay attention that here, he's framing himself the exact same way in that next shot, so that your eye is looking at the back of his head here, and you continue looking exactly there, and that's what makes this transition so nice. What you should take away from this video is like, pay attention to every single shot. There's always movement. Either it's going up, it's going down, it's going left, it's going right. That short moment with it, listen to the sound effects in the background. Now it's building up really dramatic. Most likely it's gonna come a drop in the music. And that here crazy going inside the motorcycle, who gets that idea? The color grading on that is so nice. So smooth on the transitions. Here, pay attention there to the detail. He masked out here the lens of the binoculars and then put another shot inside there. So much detail. Like, you could watch this video 10 times over and you would still find new details that he put in there. And then also for the transitions to make them more stand out or to get the viewer more into it, listen to the sound effect that he puts under it. It's like a swoosh. Such a cool shot. Shall we wonder when Benn TK is also gonna get into the FPV drone flying? That seems to be a thing with all the travel videos at the moment. That was a super smooth transition. So here again, what makes this so nice is that it's tilting up and it continues that motion. It's like one continuous motion. That's why your eye doesn't recognize the cut. So cool. And so just in that sequence here alone, one of the biggest things that should stand out to you is that he's always using foreground elements. So when he's filming people, he's always going behind an object, behind an object, behind an object, moving around. And that's what he's always using to make the transition. Here, do you see that? Pretty cool effect here when he's making that snapping a picture sound effect. And that quick boost in exposure and directional blur. Ah, what the hell? That is so crazy because it goes so fast that you can barely even process what's happening. Flying into the mountain, going through leaves, flying to another mountain, more through leaves. And here's that build up to the drop in the music, and so it's getting a lot of fast cuts now. Really, really cool. Also, what I see in a lot of videos from beginning travel filmmakers is they only film the landscape, only film drone shots and all that sort of stuff, but really what gets you engaged in the video is if you have a lot of faces, if you see emotion, that's what drags us in when we watch video. So just think about how many people he's been filming in this video. This effect also super cool here. You barely see the transition. Very short frame, completely white, and then it goes underwater and he uses a low pass filter to make it sound very muffled, like you're actually underwater. I put that alone, super cool shot. So here I'm really wondering how he got that one. Was it with the GoPro? Or a super close-up macro shot of her eye? Wow, that was crazy. And even here the transition from day to night. Do you see here? It's blending over for 3 or 4 frames. Look at the eyes. It sits in the exact same position. Even the trees in the exact same position. So smooth. These things with the tattoos, that's so... Also, what the hell. How do you edit that? I have no freaking clue. Builds up to another fast part in the music with a crazy transition. Always, of course, cliff jumping may never miss in any travel video. Ah, what the hell? As I just sit there and think, like, how long must it taken him to edit that video? Because in every single sequence, there needs to be so much time going into sorting through the footage, finding transitions that work together, finding motion that matches each other, and then putting it together in an order that makes sense. Impresses me every single time, and I cannot even wait to see his next video. Also, even that one. So, one crazy hell of a clip that he edited there. I am absolutely not at all surprised why you guys are loving his video so much, because I do too. His editing game is absolutely out of this world. So huge props for Benn for editing this video. Over there you'll find a playlist with lots more of these reaction videos. I would say until next time.